Hello there. This is a first time playthrough of Song from the Depths. Obviously I have no idea what I'm doing, but I imagine it's kind of easy. I'm hoping so anyway. But yeah, it says combat equipment is recommended and some food. So I brought combat gear, some food, some remaining potions that I had. Excalibur is always good, some teleport runes. And the rewards are one quest point, 700 constitution experience, a coral crossbow, 50 coral boats, Remora's necklace, reduced incoming damage when fighting the Queen Black Dragon, which sounds useful, and two spins on the Squeal of Fortune. Hooray! So, I'm going to go out into Rimington because that's where my house is. I hope it's not too packed, but here we go. If it is, I'll just lower my graphics down a bit. Oh yeah, apparently Rimington's had a graphic overhaul as well, so it should look quite cool. Huh, house portal looks a little different. Pretty cool. Yeah, it looks quite good actually. Just nice updated graphics. Guessing this is the house I need to go to. Okie dokie, who is this? Listen to Waylon.
Winding through the willows.
So yes, this is a voiced quest. Maybe I should turn the voices up a tiny little bit. Maybe you can hear them better, I don't know. Talk to Lucille. Song from the Depths is fully voiced and features live recorded music. We suggest that you turn your sound on. Yep, mine's
wake
on.
Wake up, Waylon, wake up!
Oh.
Come on, you great drunken oaf. This isn't funny.
Quietly leave. Ah!
Everything is not okay.
Fire Titan.
I can't wake any of these men up. They keep muttering things. Strangely similar things, as though they're all sharing the same dream. Makes no sense. I've heard rumors of men affected like this, lulled into sleep by a strange force, never to awaken again. They just lie there, empty, as though their soul just upped and left somewhere. I don't know what to do. That's my husband there, my Waylon. I don't know what I'd do without him.
Can I help?
Well, I ain't going to turn you down. Anything to get my Waylon back. I should warn you, though. A warrior named the Raptor came here before you and offered to help.
I like the Raptor. He sounds cool.
He terrified me. I'm not ashamed to admit it.
He looked awesome in that Runescape trailer.
I gave him a restless sleep potion, an old recipe I learned from a witch some time ago.
Can I have one?
She said it would let me visit the world of dreams, whatever that means. He drank it and then seemed to fade away to somewhere else. You'll need to drink it as well if you want to catch up with him.
Okay.
I'm not afraid to say that I fear the Raptor. I hear stories about him. His solution for a problem is to destroy everything linked to it. That's not who I want saving my husband. Protect my Waylon, would you? I know he's a drunkard. But he's my drunkard.
Except.
You'll need this if you want to follow the Raptor and Waylon. If it has the effect I think it will, you'll enter some kind of dream world. Then make sure you get to Waylon before the Raptor does.
I shall certainly try. Oops. Okay, I'm going to turn these sounds up a tiny little bit more. So everybody can hear them. Because I think it's... If they've gone through the trouble to record these voices and stuff, I think it's only, you know, a good thing that we actually listen to them. Alright, let's just check there's nothing else to do before I drink that. Let's see if it's giving me a rest of sleep.
Ooh.
dreaming sort of. Waylon, come back. Where are you going, Waylon? What's this well eerie music as well?
This story starts under the sea, in the home of my sisters. In that home, I found moments to sing. But I knew, if my sisters heard me, they would roll up some kelp and force it into my mouth. So I learned to sing quietly. One night, my sisters were out hunting. I swam from my home and came upon a village on the edge of the sea. There were so many people on the docks, working and talking, but they could not see me in the dark water. So I sang to them.
Keep talking, witch. Makes it easier to find you. If you're here to stop me, then you have a problem. And that problem is standing in front of you. It's too late to save Waylon.
Come to me, my men. Gather to hear my story.
Only thing left to do is kill her.
Why? What did she do?
Keep your distance. Don't try to stop me.
No, come back, raptor man.
So I sang an old mermaid song, and the men on the docks listened.
Fly fish, drift on the northern wind. Goldfish, bask in the western sun.
Oops. Oh, so many options. Which way do I go? Oh wait, western sun. It's this way. West.
So I sang an old mermaid song, and the men on the docks listened.
Fly fish, drift on the northern wind. Goldfish, bask in the western sun.
Does that mean north and west? Southeast now. These caves are pretty creepy, gotta say.
The sailors on the dock heard my song, and I could see the adoration on their faces. I drank it all in, but then they stepped into the sea. None of the men made an effort to swim, and they drowned. I lifted the dead bodies back onto the land. I could barely swim home with the sorrow. My sisters taunted me. Even the town changed its name to Witch Haven, as if to remind me of what I had done.
Forward.
Oh. I mean, I can't follow. Oh.
I knew I should warn those men, but I could only think of their adoring looks and the effect they had on me. So I swam for the town again. This time, I climbed onto the land and sang for the men of the fields. There was no water to drown in, and they looked at me with such love.
Symbols discovered. Is it these things, the symbols? Those? What is the symbols? I just have to run around and hope I stand on something. Oh.
But then the men saw one another. They became jealous.
Oh no.
And they fought. They hacked at each other, beating flesh and bones with rocks.
A door appears. You see like a red line on the map. I don't see one. That's the way I came in. It looked like some guy before just like disappeared through this wall, but I don't have a door. Something strange about this part of the wall. Confused. I'm pretty sure that's the way I came in. Oh wait, no, that's the way I came in. That was stupid. Let's find another thing on the floor. Oh.
As I learned new songs, I found I could affect men in other ways. One song allowed me to attract the souls of dreaming men. They would love me, even as they slept.
Is this voice going to secretly be the Queen Black Dragon?
Night or day, I was surrounded by those who loved me, and I loved them back.
A door appears. It's my door.
I found myself walking the world, sharing the love of dreaming souls. It was overpowering. It came so easy to me. But one day, I came across a soul that would not love me. A furious soul. It burned with rejection, fear, and hatred. It ignored me.
I'm just getting quite into this. I like the voice quests. It adds a good layer of depth to them.
Approached the furious soul. It screamed as if on fire. I tried to soothe it with song, but still it seethed. So I cried a tear, and the water extinguished the fire.
Plant in plant pot. Do they have different examines? Covering cobwebs. Living fungi. Water flowing over its surface. Ivy. Okay. I'm guessing I need to get something from each one and then put them in the pots. The store is locked. Do something here. Okay. So can I plant in first or what? Take burning sapling. Supposed to do that?